Hey, this is Nate Story with Bright Agritech, and today we're going to continue the nutrient series by talking a little bit about the plant micronutrient zinc. So zinc is one of the micronutrients, which means it's not as important as, say, a macronutrient or a secondary macronutrient, but it's still essential for plant growth and development. So in aquaponic systems, zinc is very rarely deficient. I've never seen it, honestly, and I don't anticipate I will. One of the reasons for this is that there's always enough zinc in fish feed, so all of the fish feed going into the system contains enough zinc for your plants. And oftentimes people are using galvanized steel parts in their system, whether they realize it or not. So one of the reasons that it's important to talk about zinc, even though it's very rarely deficient in your plants, is because zinc can be very toxic to your fish. So it's one of those things that you want to keep a close eye on, not necessarily because there's not enough zinc in your system, but because oftentimes there's too much. Fish are really, really sensitive to zinc. So people that are using galvanized steel in their system in large quantities run the risk of poisoning their fish. So it's one of those things where when we're talking to beginning aquaponics folks, you know, we always stay away from galvanized steel. If you must use galvanized steel, make sure you're coating it in a very nice thick industrial epoxy. Now, over time, algae can actually grow on the sides of those galvanized steel tanks. And galvanized steel, in case you don't know, is just zinc plated steel. That algae, as it grows on there, that biofilm can actually seal off that zinc over time. So you will see some established older systems. You'll see stock tanks. You'll see, you know, these containers that will have fish in them that are made of galvanized steel. And you may look at that and say, hey, well, you know, they're doing it. Why can't I? Well, the difference is there's probably a lot of fish that died to get to that point where that galvanized steel was completely sealed off from the rest of the system solution. So it's kind of one of those things where it's just easier starting off, just coat it in epoxy, or just plain don't use galvanized steel at all if you can help it. Now there's always going to be things like fasteners that do contain galvanized steel or are made of galvanized steel, and there's not a whole lot you can do about those besides just using stainless steel, but that can be a pretty pricey option. So make sure you're thinking really carefully about the plated steel or the galvanized steel that you're using in your system, and try to stay away from zinc plated as often as you can, or make sure that it's sealed up really well. So to recap, zinc is a plant micronutrient and it's really important for plant development, but in aquaponic systems, it's most relevant in the context of killing your fish, of poisoning your fish. So make sure you're keeping an eye on the zinc in your system, make sure you're limiting it, and trust that the fish feed that you're using has enough zinc for your plants and enough zinc for your fish, and you really don't need to be adding any more to your system. Thanks so much for watching this video. If it's useful to you, please subscribe. Make sure you check out the Vertical Food blog. We'll go into a little bit more detail over there on zinc, what it does for the plants, how it hurts your fish, and how to control how much is in your system at any given time.
We'll use kelp to supplement potassium in their system because it's pH neutral.
So there are a lot of other substances that you can use. And depending on kind of how your system runs,